Hi Gemini, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity in your personal lives, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Geminians, it's quite a busy month. We have your ruler Mercury that is retrograde this entire month till about 23rd. We have two new moons, in fact. One is a solar eclipse, and then we have another, a bonus new moon towards the end of the month. And the biggie this month is Jupiter that is changing signs from Virgo to Libra around 10th of September. We have a new moon as we begin the month in your house of home. This is a place where you share with others. It's a place of where you go for your emotional retreat. It's your home. It's a place where you recharge your emotional batteries as well. And with the new moon over here, your home and family seem to be quite in focus this month for you. At a personal developmental stage, it's not a time really to be listening to what is it in your gut, but also to be paying homage to those feelings as well, Geminians. What makes you feel safe and secure is going to be the question for you this entire month. Now, although this house primarily is concerned with your home, this is also quite a angular and a cardinal house, and it stirs up some amount of activity as well for you. So it's a time for reorganization. It's a time of heightened awareness about your roots, issues of intimacy, of vulnerability. And it's also an excellent time to come in touch with your feelings and your needs as well. Focusing on your support system during this time and the manner in which you support others is also probable. It's a good time to be making long-range plans for the future, and it's a time to be reorganizing or even remodeling of the home or home environment or family-related activities. Now, the irony also is that we have Mercury that is there retrograde this entire month. So while we have a new moon, Mercury is urging you to review. It's asking you to rethink things that are there around which have to do with your home. It's asking you to step back and saying that while there are a lot of opportunities that are there, you need to be using them quite wisely. And don't hesitate to question your own fundamental values as to what is it that your conditioning has brought you up to think and be the way that you are. And small insights can lead you to larger gains, Geminians, during this entire phase. And by the end of this Mercury retrograde, that is about till 23rd of September, you'll find that the re-evaluation has been highly useful for you, because you're going to be depending more on yourself to evolve into what is it that the future has in store for you. So this space of trying to sort of, whether it is looking at your support system, whether it is questioning it, whether there is too much of dependence that you have on your family, it's a time really to be taking self-accountability as well. We have Jupiter that is changing signs on the 10th. It's moving from Virgo to Libra, and it's going to be there till about 10th of October 2017, and it's joining Venus in this part of your house. And this is happening in your house of love, romance, children, creativity. So a lot of good times, Geminians, you can expect to be spending a lot of time with your children. They could be a source of happiness for you. Your creativity could be at its peak. You could be finding yourself being very self-expressive. You could be finding that the creative projects are doing very well. You could feel quite inspired, quite motivated. And you'll find that your love and romance will really enhance your life, and a lot of good humor, and letting your child out and play, a lot of fun times over here. And you're going to be feeling quite free from responsibility as well with this entire Jupiter phase. And because Jupiter is there for this entire year, I think it's a wonderful place for Jupiter to be, because you have 12 months to really sort of, you know, be free of tensions, be free of really things that it could have been bugging you down. And because this has to do around creativity, around children, there could finally be some clarity, there could be some ease, there could be some comfort that could be there. And even for some of you who are pregnant or are looking at getting pregnant, this is a great time that you'll find yourself, wanting maybe another child. Jupiter is the planet of expansion, and he's the god of the sky as per Greek mythology, Zeus. and he's a god of plenty. But also with Jupiter is that, you know, because abundance in too much, anything in too much, you have to sort of draw the balance. So try and sort of not go all towards fun and games and forget about responsibilities and say, okay, you know, I can just sort of lie back and not be responsible. Now, be a little cautious of that, you know, life still needs to be dealt with over here. Around the 16th, we have a lunar eclipse that is there in your house of career, accolades, reputation, and it's joining Neptune. And it can be for some of you, you may just change jobs or maybe a project comes to an end and you could be, you could feel quite watched, or it could be that some of you are up for review and you could get some accolades, and you could find that maybe dealing with authorities is getting to be a bit too much and you don't want to deal with it. You could find the space being quite limited and limiting or quite restrictive as well. But try and sort of network during this phase, try and reach out to more people, and be your own brand ambassador, Geminians, at workplace. You know, speak more about the value that you're bringing to the organization. And for some of you, you could just decide to do a new direction. You know, so if you've been working at the corporate, you may just give it up and you may just start something of your own, or you may just go to another company that is without structures. It's like a startup, you know, so it's more flexible than the organizations that you have been used to. But use this time to evaluate your commitments and your long-term goals, and whether or not you know, there's a whether or not, you know, what is the end result of that goal, will it be a grand success. But get down to sort of planning it, putting it in proper, you know, in ink it down, so to speak. You know, don't just let those be thoughts in your head. Around the 23rd, we have Mercury that is finally going direct, and it's a time again to start conversations. It's a time to be signing deals. It's a time to be doing negotiations, picking up that new job offer, maybe going for interviews, time to be buying a new car during the Mercury going direct. During the entire month when Mercury is retrograde, try and be onto the place of research, Geminians. Don't sort of jump and take action into things. Around the 24th, we have Venus that is moving into your house of day-to-day chores. It's your house of fitness, diet. And with Venus being out there, it's a good time to be tackling with things which may seem quite mundane but need to get done. So you could find it, you could find them quite satisfying, I think, because there's a lot of support around you. You won't find them very boring. However, try and sort of, for those of you who have a sweet tooth, try and watch yourself. Don't overeat, and watch your health around this time. Around the 28th, we have Mars that is there in your house of joint finances, intimacy and sexuality, and we have Pluto over there as well. And this is a time wherein that you are going to be, there is this time where you're going to be seeing, it's not really a power struggle, but I think again it's a, you may feel that you know, you have to, there could be a sense of resentment that you're having to do more than it is required. So just watch out for that resentment, Geminians. Try to sort of, you know, try to look at the complete picture. Don't just look at specifics in your life and then be reactive. And Mars is going to be sort of bringing about that aggression and restlessness. So try not to sort of, you know, get angry or even use it in words, and you know, be careful, because it could sort of get the similar response in others as well. So be careful about that. Around the 30th, we have a new moon in Libra, and that is there in your house of love, romance, children and creativity. So we're ending the month on a fantastic note. So a lot of fun times in September, Geminians. Have a lovely month. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.